Beyonce.
Who daddy wanna say?
I just put Beyonce daddy. Ah! Hey guys, today I am going to teach you how to roast the perfect chicken. It's great for a holiday season. It's great if you're like me and you do a roast every Sunday. So easy, and it will have everyone drooling. What you're gonna need for this recipe is stick of butter, thyme, rosemary, lemon, garlic, salt and pepper. If you wanna leave out the stick of butter, you can, but it kind of adds the magic to the dish. You must preheat your oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. First, you're gonna have your chicken. You're gonna let this come to room temperature because all meat is better cooked when it's at room temperature. We're going to pat the chicken dry, like so. Then, we are going to get our stick of butter. I'm gonna get another chopping board because I don't like to mix raw meats with other things. So we're just gonna move our chicken off to the side a little bit. We're gonna unwrap our butter, cut it into kind of like tablespoons. Great if the butter's quite cold as well, so it maintains its structure. Figure out the space between the breast and the skin in the chicken, like so. Very interesting feeling. Put the butter underneath the skin. For the inside of the chicken, we're gonna get a big lemon. We're gonna put some holes in it with a skewer so that when this lemon heats up, it's gonna just squirt lemon juice throughout the chicken, which is gonna be delicious. So using some thyme and some rosemary. Wrap our lemon with our herbs and we're gonna shove it in the back, like so. Get our garlic. Use about 6 bulbs, I think. Chop it up. What's inside the chicken is what's gonna infuse the chicken with an aroma. Ours is gonna be lemon, garlic, and herb throughout the meat. So my oven is heating. I'm gonna finish off by throwing my garlic into all different sides. I personally like to just close the cavity so we can get as much of the skin as possible. So I came up with this idea of threading, like sewing the skewer to close the cavity. You just get the edges and you just press it in. And then when you get to the bottom, you're gonna just sew up the bottom cavity as well. And then close it, like that. And then we're just gonna snap off the top. So now we've got our chicken sewn up, the cavity. Now we're gonna add some salt and pepper and start to rub that in. So lovely, so messy. I forgot a key ingredient, truffle salt, which I use a lot in a lot of my recipes. Sprinkle some truffle salt on top. That's gonna have the whole household drooling. Gotta make sure you get everything, the wings, everything. Massage that in. This is gonna be a good chicken. It always is. Truffle salt is key. Olive oil is very important. Make sure you get a good quality olive oil, just like a bottle of wine. We're gonna get our baking dish. If you wanted, you could actually add your chicken directly onto the shelf in the oven. And then you could put this underneath and have all of the fats drip into it and you could use it for your gravy. I am just going to put some olive oil onto my baking dish and then we're gonna lay our chicken on top. And our oven is preheated to 375 degrees. We are going to get this guy in. Really easy, it's all about the prep. We're just gonna put this in for 45 minutes. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna baste our chicken like so. It's looking great. I don't know if you guys can see that. I don't know if you can see what I can see. Look at that magic right there. And we're gonna put it back in for another 45 minutes. If you don't have one of these, you could also use a spoon. Just spoon over all the juices and butter. Okay guys, it's time to take our chicken out of the oven. Let's do this. Do you hear that? Let's see how it's doing. You see that? No juices come out. That is perfect. Our chicken's done. We're gonna plate it. It's great with smashed potatoes, which you can find the recipe below. It's also great with roasted vegetables, and we're gonna make all the juices into a yummy, yummy gravy. The gravy is the best.